Korean sunscreens have a reputation for being extremely lightweight, comfortable, and affordable. But have you ever wondered what sunscreens are actually popular in Korea? Well, today I'll tell you all you need to know on the number one best-selling sunscreens in Korea. Hello everyone, and welcome or welcome back to my channel. If it's the first time you visit this channel, my name is Odile and I work as an art director in the beauty industry in South Korea. On this channel, I use my professional experience to bring you informative content on Korean beauty trends and history. So if you like to take your K-beauty knowledge to the next level, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications. In today's video, I'll walk you through Dr. G sunscreens, so hopefully you can get a better understanding of the features of each sunscreen in their catalog and decide if there's something that could fit your skin and lifestyle. The first sunscreen I'll show you is the iconic Green Mild Up Sun Plus. The Green Mild Up Sun Plus is without doubt Dr. G's most popular sunscreen. In fact, it was recognized as the number one best-selling sunscreen in Korea for the past three consecutive years. It's a mineral sunscreen designed with sensitive skin in mind. The only UV filter of this sunscreen is zinc oxide, which is the filter that is most commonly recommended for people with extremely sensitive and reactive skin. Plus, this sunscreen doesn't contain any fragrance, alcohol, essential oils, or any other ingredient that could potentially irritate sensitive skin. At this point, you might wonder, there are many mineral sunscreens that are suitable for sensitive skin. What's so special about this one? The main reason behind the success of the Green Mild Up Sun Plus is that it's a mineral sunscreen that even people that usually stay away from mineral sunscreens can enjoy. For starters, the formula of this sunscreen feels really comfortable. If you've ever tried a zinc oxide sunscreen in your life, you will know that zinc oxide is one of the most drying ingredients out there, which might sound great for oily skin, but not so much for everyone else. The formula of this sunscreen is like the perfect middle ground. It forms a thin film on the surface of the skin that helps trap hydration in dry skin. But at the same time, it doesn't contain any oil or heavy occlusives and dries with a natural semi-matte finish. In terms of white cast, like the vast majority of mineral sunscreens out there, this sunscreen does leave a white cast. But personally, I find that this is the Korean mineral sunscreen with the most minimal white cast I've ever tried. On a scale from 0 to 10, where 0 is crystal clear and 10 is white as a ghost, I would rate the white cast of this sunscreen a 4 out of 10. Next, let's take a look at the latest addition to the Green Mild Up Sun Care range, the Green Mild Up Sun Essence. The Green Mild Up Sun Essence was launched last year, and you might remember it from the video on my favorite sunscreens from last summer. Unlike the Green Mild Up Sun Plus, this sunscreen only contains chemical UV filters and it's meant to be a comfortable daily sunscreen with a lightweight and hydrating texture. The great thing about this sunscreen is that besides being really hydrating, it also provides great skin barrier support thanks to ingredients like provitamin D, glycerin, and 8 types of hyaluronic acid. As you can see, the Green Mild Up Sun Essence has a lotion cream formula that is absorbed easily without stickiness, greasiness, or shine. In terms of white cast, the formula is completely transparent straight out of the tube, and I'm pretty positive this should be suitable for all skin tones. If you have dry skin that is prone to dehydration like me, you're probably going to love this formula. It has just the perfect ratio of water and oil, nice spreadability, and great barrier support to minimize water loss during the day. It does contain fragrance, but it's very subtle and not overpowering. I would describe the fragrance as a fresh, powdery scent with cotton and musk undernotes. Next, let's talk about Dr. G's brightening up some plus. And just so you know, the tube you see in the picture is a promotional size. The standard full size is 50 ml, like the other sunscreens. The Brightening Up Sun Plus is the sunscreen that put Dr. G sunscreens on the map. It rose to fame in 2016 for being the sunscreen that actress Kim Ji-won wore on the set of Descendants of the Sun, and has been a constant bestseller ever since. The main selling point of this sunscreen is that it's a multifunctional product created for people who are looking to minimize their skincare routine. It's a hybrid sunscreen with a light peach tone that helps revive the appearance of dull skin. It's a tinted sunscreen that overcomes the shortcomings of most tinted sunscreens. Usually with tinted sunscreens, there are two options out there. You have tone-up sunscreens that are used to create the illusion of lighter skin, or you have skin-toned tinted sunscreens that look awfully cakey if applied in the right amount. The formula of the Brightening Up Sun Plus is most similar to a color-correcting makeup base. It has a sheer coverage, so you can apply the right amount without worrying about looking like a clown. And the peach tone really works wonders to neutralize dullness. The particular thing about this sunscreen is that it was formulated with a sebum controlling complex that helps absorb excess oil during the day, which is fantastic if you struggle with excess sebum and shine, but not so much for dry skin. If you have dry skin like me, this sunscreen will look good for maybe 2 hours if you apply it on top of a heavy-duty moisturizer. And after that, your face will gradually start looking like a raisin. So overall, I would say that this could be a great sunscreen for people with oily skin and a light to medium skin tone. To be honest with you, I'm not too sure this would work for darker skin tones. Even though it provides a shield coverage, it still contains mineral filters, so I have a feeling that this would look ashy on dark skin. Next, we have the new Red Blemish Soothing Up Sun, launched last month. This is one of the new Korean sunscreen releases I was looking forward to the most this year. I already talked about how much I love Dr. G's Red Blemish Clear Soothing Up Cream on this channel, and this sunscreen is marketed as the equivalent of Dr. G's iconic soothing cream in sunscreen form. So, of course, I had to try it. This is a chemical sunscreen with a soothing and hypoallergenic formula designed to hydrate and relieve sensitive skin. Like the other products in the Red Blemish line, the sunscreen contains a soothing complex that helps reduce redness and irritation, and you can really get a sense of it when you apply the product, because the formula feels very fresh without being uncomfortably cooling, if you know what I mean. I must say that the thing that impressed me the most the first time I tried this sunscreen is how genuinely lightweight the formula feels. Not just in terms of spreadability, but also in terms of finish. It's one of those formulas that sinks into the skin like a hydrating essence, and then you just forget about it. It genuinely feels like wearing nothing. And this is also true in terms of white cast. The formula is 100% transparent straight out of the tube, and I'm confident this will be suitable even for darker skin tones. This sunscreen doesn't contain fragrance, alcohol, or essential oils, and the oil content of the formula is close to zero. This makes the Red Blemish Soothing Up Sun especially suitable for sensitive, oily, and acne-prone skin. If you have dry skin like me, this is not the type of sunscreen that you can wear in place of your day moisturizer. So you can either wear it on top of a more emollient cream, or in combination with a more moisturizing foundation if you wear makeup. Next, let's move on to another new release, and it's the Nice Birdie Up Sun. The Nice Birdie Up Sun is an outdoor sunscreen that provides strong resistance against UV rays, sweat, oil, and sand. If you don't know the difference between a daily sunscreen and an outdoor sunscreen, I recommend checking out the video I made last summer on my top sunscreens. In short, outdoor sunscreens are very resistant sunscreens that are not easily removed even when exposed to strong sunlight, sweat, or water, for example. This outdoor sunscreen in particular was mainly created with golf playing in mind. As you might notice from the name of the product and all the golf references that Dr. G makes in their promotional materials. This is relevant because while the vast majority, if not all, outdoor sunscreens are water resistant, this sunscreen is not. The Nice Birdie Up Sun was formulated with a watershed powder that acts as a waterproof coating when it comes in contact with oil or sweat. But technically, it was not tested to be water resistant according to the legal standards in Korea. So I would say that this sunscreen is only suitable for sports and outdoor activities that don't involve water. Except for that, I must say that it's a great sunscreen with outstanding resistance. As soon as you apply it, you will feel the formula immediately gripping on the skin. And in my experience, it won't budge an inch even after spending an entire day under strong sunlight. The sunscreen has a creamy formula with great spreadability that dries with a natural, chewy, but silky finish. So even though it does have a little bit of sheen, it's not sticky to the touch. In terms of white cast, this sunscreen does leave a minimal white cast, but it's almost completely transparent when I fully massage it on my fair skin. On a scale from 0 to 10, I would rate the white cast of this sunscreen a 1. Next, let's move on to the Medi UV Suncare range, starting from the most popular Medi UV Ultra Up Sun Plus. The Medi UV Ultra Up Sun Plus has an interesting story. This sunscreen was originally available only in PX stores in South Korea. If you don't know, PX stores are shops that operate in military bases and where active soldiers can purchase all sorts of basic necessities at a discounted price. In South Korea, it's common for beauty brands with a big male following to release products exclusively for PX stores. Sometimes they're just simplified versions of existing products, or they can also be entirely new products. This sunscreen was exclusive to PX stores, but over time it became so popular among soldiers that Dr. G decided to make it available to the general public last year. The main selling point of this sunscreen is that it's a very resistant sunscreen with a comfortable formula that even people that usually hate wearing sunscreen could enjoy. It's a hybrid sunscreen that strongly adheres to the skin and dries with a comfortable semi-matte finish that genuinely feels like second skin. I feel this is a good middle ground between a daily sunscreen and an outdoor sunscreen. It has a stronger adhesion power compared to your average daily sunscreen, but it's still comfortable like a daily sunscreen, and it's also easier to remove in the evening compared to an outdoor sunscreen. The only downside of this sunscreen is that it does leave a little bit of a white cast. It's not dramatic, but it's still noticeable even on fair skin. On a scale from 0 to 10, I would rate the white cast left by this sunscreen a 6 out of 10. Overall, if you're looking for a resistant sunscreen and you find that waterproof formulas are too hard to remove and you don't mind a minimal white cast, this is something that you could consider. Despite the mild white cast, the feeling of use is great and it's honestly one of Dr. G's most comfortable sunscreens. It does contain fragrance, but it's very subtle. It's a light musky scent with a unisex appeal. Lastly, we have the Medi UV Mild Sun, launched last year. Following the popularity of the Medi UV Ultra Up Sun Plus, Dr. G decided to release a version of the sunscreen using only zinc oxide as a UV filter. The result is the Medi UV Mild Up Sun, a resistant mineral sunscreen designed designed for sensitive skin. Compared to the standard version, the Medi UV Matte Sun has a more hydrating formula that dries with a natural, dewy finish. The finish is not matte, but it's not exactly sticky either. It's somewhere in between. It's more of a natural, hydrating finish. The main downside of this sunscreen is that it leaves a very noticeable white cast. In fact, this is probably the Dr. G sunscreen with the most obvious white cast. Even after fully massaging the sunscreen, it's still very noticeable, as you can see. Except for the white cast, the sunscreen has a great feeling of use like the standard version. So I would say that if you're in the market for a mineral sunscreen because you can't use chemical filters, and you don't like the semi-matte finish of the Green Matte Up Sun Plus, this is something that you could consider. Otherwise, just go for the Green Matte Up Sun Plus. That was all for today. If you're interested in knowing more technical details on all these sunscreens, including the full ingredient list, I manually translated all available information for you, and you will find the link in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching, and please don't forget to like and subscribe for more informative content on Korean beauty. See you next time. Bye!